on third down, Romo. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. This guy was a secondary's worst nightmare last week. He had a huge game catching the football in that win. If he's able to do even close to that same amount of damage in this one, they should be looking at another victory for sure. It's the Buccaneers going up against the Cowboys. Set for the call of this Week 15 matchup, here are Brandon Gotten and Charles Davis.
We are sandwiched between Fort Worth and Dallas, Texas in Arlington at the luxurious AT&T Stadium. Today, we reach Week 15, and we've got a good... They'll come out in the pistol. They run with a rookie. Here's Elliott. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. So a look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. They tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stocked your team just the way you're supposed to.
Hey, the defense is in this game as well. They wanted to make it a tough third down. They were able to do so on that last play, preventing a big gain.
And the box with an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. Romo now to throw it, and that's caught by Beasley. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line.
Love the call by the offensive coordinator, recognizing the situation very well, calling for the play-action pass, and completing it.
And the offense lining up first and 10. Romo gives to Elliott, and he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Here's Romo, and this one complete to Witten over the middle. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
And another reception by Jason Witten. All reliable for Tony Romo. You know what they say, partner. Once you get your first 1,000 catches, it's all gravy after that.
Yeah, one of two tight ends. He and Tony Gonzalez in the 1,000 catch club in the tight end department. A first down carry by Elliott. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
One quarter in the books. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon as it is Cowboy football to begin quarter number two. They've got a second down and eight to start things out.
Let's go!
To throw on second down is Romo. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
Seventh play of the drive forthcoming on third.
Go, go, go! Check, check, check! Go.
Throwing on third down, Romo. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
I know that in recent years, it's been tough on Tony Romo. A lot of injuries have piled up, but he's still able to sling it, Brandon. Look at that throw.
Yeah, he can. By the way, you know his given name on his birth certificate?
Hit me, hit me.
Antonio Ramiro Romo.
That, you know, that flows
together.
He's
got a good ring,
well,
so I'm going to start calling him Antonio.
The lyrical one.
Now back to the ground with Elliott. Trying to turn the corner, but he's going to be stopped right near the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
On that play, it was the defensive front that won the battle. They out-leveraged the offensive line, got into the backfield, and held him to no gain.
Here's Romo now on second down. Throwing middle, and it's complete. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't
they?
Yeah,
when we talked about him.
They like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time. Really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. The four-time Pro Bowler, Gerald McCoy, in there to bury him for a loss of 11. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on.
Let's go now. Check, check, check. Gun, gun, gun.
They fake the give to Elliott. Now Romo. Can't find anyone open. Drops it underneath to Elliott. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Give him 7 on the play, and that is going to set up third and goal.
Right, I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65.
Bryant with a catch right side. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves them just... And now here come the Cowboys. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But you also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
On second down, Elliott. And now the Bucs deciding to take a timeout defensively.
So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
They've got an extra defensive back out there now on 3rd and 13. He's got a man that's caught left sideline. A big play there on the catch and run. 74 yards.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
Now Romo. And this is caught for a touchdown. Now hold everything here. Flag in the backfield. This one might be coming back.
Holding offense.
So oftentimes you see defensive holding. Here it's offensive holding for the flag.
Ready.
Out of the gun. Romo throwing over the middle. It's incomplete.
Let's go, 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 go.
On second down, here's Romo. That is caught. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Now they've gotten it to the one. Can they get that final yard here on third and goal? Romo looks to throw on 3rd and 1. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Jason.
the Cowboys now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. Second and just one. Romo. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Quan Alexander. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. Dallas gets set to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. To throw on second down is Romo. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. Yeah, quick throw here, that's complete. A gain of seven, and they pick up the first.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. Here's Romo. And Beasley with it over the middle. And he's going to get this inside the 30. They'll get 16 yards there. And it'll be first down, Cowboys. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
Takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver because you got to read those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone, sometimes you're throwing it between the zones, sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
Elliott, and he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Romo now to throw it. Drops it underneath to Elliott. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down.
Holding offense.
So there you go, holding by the offense, and that'll push him back.
Changes everything now as you try and figure out what your playbook has for you. Longer yardage situations, tougher to execute and pick up first downs.
One man in the backfield, Elliott. Third and long here, it's Romo. He's got time in the pocket, and he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. So out come the Cowboys now as their offense gets set to take over. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted, and we can't do that.
And now with the play clock winding down, Jason Garrett opts to take a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now Romo. His throw incomplete.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down.
Guys, go, go! White 18!
From his goal line here, Romo. He's going to be sacked. Tony Romo sacked in the end zone, so that's going to be a safety. And the Dallas gets set to take the field. And the last time they had the football, they surrendered two points on the safety. And they don't want to do that one again.
No, not at all. It's almost like a bases clearing double, isn't it? Give up a couple of runs.
Sure.
just messes things up for you offensively. But now they've got to go ahead, take it, set it aside, and move forward.
Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
Bryant, the lone receiver, left. Second and 10. Romo once more. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Quan Alexander. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And he will find his man on the end route, complete. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it.
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Quan Alexander. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. Now the Cowboys' offense heads back onto the field. Another pistol look here. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He's going to float this one deep. And this will be caught at the 30. It's a big play. Romo to Bryant. 48 yards. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme arrogance with you and continue to fire the ball.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Brad McDougal. Dallas gets set to take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Romo surveying the field. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. That's incomplete. Nearly another pick. My goodness.
Well, partner, I think the defensive fellas got the memo, and they decided to cover him on that play.
Yeah, he's already up over 100 yards in this game. They tried a deep shot, couldn't get it.
Yeah, when you've had that much success, finally, someone said, let's try and put a stop to it and put people on it.
He completes it to Bryant. Now he will have a first down here at about the 40. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? Here we go. The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
And they're going to hurry back to the line now. So deja vu all over again. Another good week. And sometimes maybe because the defense. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Obviously a tough spot here. They need a lot of luck to win this game, but still a small chance.
They've got to make sure they get the ball to the sidelines, get out of bounds, preserve clock.
Now Romo. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side.
Black 35, half, half, half. Slam. Gun, gun, gun.
Motion backfield, Romo. Finding time. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by the first rounder, Vernon Hargraves.